Hello Gundam fans, this is Prime92, and today I'll be looking at the 10144 Deathscythe Hell from the Gundam Wing series. Now this is a very old kit. It's 1995-ish, around when the actual series... It was when the actual series came out in Japan. It's, yeah, it's pretty old. It looks like the Deathscythe Hell, that's for sure. Although, I don't think the proportions are exactly right, but you know what? It's not too bad. Back in the day, this was really good. And, it would be nice to have an updated version of this, but it's okay. It could be better, that's for sure. It does have quite a few stickers. You got the eyes. There was a chin sticker, but I removed it. Just put some Gundam marker on there. All the gold on the chest. The gray on the front skirts. All the white on the shield here. Slash cloak, and the red are stickers. And surprisingly enough, there's a lot of new pieces on the actual model compared to the original Deathscythe. Like the chest, the shoulders, the lower arms, the feet. I'm pretty sure these side skirts are just taken from the Wing Gundam. I'd have to take it off the shelf and look. And the backpack. And of course the new shield pieces. But yeah, there's quite a few pieces that I originally assumed. So, you know what? Judging it from today's standards, it's not that good, but back in the day, it was a good kit. And once again, articulation's not going to be that good. Head goes up and down a little. It will rotate 360, but just barely. It does have a rather pronounced chin. The arms go forwards and back and out that far. Bend at the elbow at one joint. Rotate at the elbow. Rotate at the wrist and wiggle. The waist goes that far. Front skirts barely at all. Side skirts a little bit more. And because of that, the legs can only go that far forwards. Barely back at all, out a little. The knees are double jointed and they do bend about 90 degrees, which is as good as they can considering the design. And the feet force back, side to side a little, and rotate. And then of course you got the shields, which can come down all the way. And they have little clips that can lock into place in the front and in the back. And the side pieces can also move in and out and rotate since they're on a polycap. So, all in all, you know, it is pretty limited, but I think the added articulation in the actual shields does help it a little bit, especially compared to other mobile suits. It does give a little bit of display option, although this does need a bigger shelf like that. But you know what? It's okay. It definitely could be a lot better, but it's alright. So, on the actual Deathscythe, you can have the compacted Noble Scythe on the back skirt. Just goes right into the hole. You also get in the kit the original Scythe folded up, so you can switch if you want. You also get, of course, the extended version of the Twin Scythe, which does actually have articulation. Now you got a joint here and here at the beams, and a double joint here. So you can have it folded up, or out, or hey, you can even do a propeller. I don't know, I never understood the whole Twin Scythe thing, because I'm pretty sure he only used it like that. I mean, the thruster helps, I guess, because it, you know, faster motion, but I don't, unless it's going to do something like that, so we can, like, spear and then stab, I don't know. It's alright. Although, if you don't like it, once again, you get the old one. And this piece is, the reason it's differently colored is it is the old blade from the original. And this is the new one, so you can switch it and have the original Scythe if you don't like the twin one. That's no problem. And it does fit rather securely in the old-style hand. You can probably get it in both hands if you try. And you also get the shield, which is a lot more decorative than the original. You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 stickers on the shield. So it would look pretty boring if you didn't have those. And then it has the thrusters here, and the blades, which are on a gear system. And you have the plastic effect part. And it'll just peg into the forearm. It is a little hard to get it around all the stuff on them. But once you get on there, it's there. I wouldn't hit it too much. It's not quite flush against the arm, but it should stay. So accessories are, well, more than you'd expect, because you do get the option to switch them if you want for the older style weapons. And this is what I had in the show, so can't really complain. Now, of course, I'm going to compare the Deathscythe Hell with the original Deathscythe. And now you can definitely see all the parts that have been changed on the two. How the chest is a lot bulkier on the new one, but the arms are slimmer. You got the pointy feet on the new one. Of course, the big shield cloak thingy. The new scythe, and as you can see here, it is the exact... The old one is the same as the extra one you get. And the old beam is that top one. And there goes that shield. And the, see, the back skirt's a lot bigger on the new one. Backpack's the same. So yeah, that is the Deathscythe Hell. Yeah, it's an old kit, but if you want one of this scale, the Deathscythe Hell, you kinda gotta go over this way for a model kit. It'd be great to have a new version, but I doubt that's gonna happen anytime soon. And this actually completes my 1-144 wing kits from the 90s. I have them all. Well, all the normal lineup, not the limited edition ones like the Leo and the, I think, the Taurus. I think the Ares is there too. Those things are friggin' expensive, so the normal line, I have them all. Started collecting these about 1999, so it's taken over 10 years to get them all, but I finally do. So that's about it, and I'll see you at the next review.